see how important those pauses are. So the, and the pauses keeps her looking up. She's, we wanted to do, you might even want to go back to the place board a little bit and work on the pauses on the place board so there's no positional component about it. You want, when the food stops, boom, she should be looking up and going, it's going to happen. It's going to happen any second. And this time, wait for a couple of seconds. You're going to be looking up and do a head turn and then do a left. Better figure it out. She's going to go. She's going to go. She's a little confused. Just have to figure it out. All right, start over again. So walk off the board. So walk off the board. We don't want to reward her for being crooked. So you can just walk off the board and start over again. So it's kind of cute now, but as the behaviors become more complex, because she's going to be a little confused, we don't want to start barking. Although it's good information, if she starts barking, you know she's confused. So she's not sure about what she's supposed to be doing right now.
Good.
And I wouldn't say anything, just because the good is also the rule. Now pause. Good. Just a couple pieces. And then another pause. Pause. Good. Okay. Every time you pause, she looks down for food you might have brought. Okay, so let's go ahead and have a seat. Let's talk about what's going on. So a couple things. We want to begin to reduce the rate of reward between the pauses. 3 to 5, no more than that. And do a lot of pauses. So, and you want to build the pauses up to 10, 15 second pauses where she just stares right up at you going, it's going to happen any second, any second. She patterns really, really fast.
And so she
pattern frames really, really fast, which in IPO is actually a pretty good thing. But when she thinks that she's done and she thinks she should get more food, then she starts throwing behaviors. So we don't want her to do that. So those pauses are going to be really critical in her overall development of healing. And in the end, to get her BH, all you need is a really good healing pattern, a sit, and a down. And that's it. That's all you need. You're going to be making, of course, turns, so you need one about turn. You actually need 2 about turns, you need 2 right turns, and you need 1 left turn. So these are the things that we need to work on. The right turn is going to happen much later. If we start doing the right turns now, she's going to start going out and away. And we don't want her to do that. So the left turns are going to keep her close. And it's always going to keep her sucking into you. So in your home and training, we do a lot of heels, a lot of fooses on the perch, and then foos go to the wall, go up the wall, and right back to the perch. So you want her to get her healing, so you'd be standing whichever way you want. So you'd be doing this, you then look left, turn, then a right turn, but slightly back. So watch how I do the wall, the right one. So she's here, you're gonna look, you're gonna do a left turn, and then as you approach the wall, you back and then go forward. To give her a chance to swing around and a couple of steps forward, then back, and see if you can do a 180 back to the touchpad. So the old, just really tiny bits of forward motion against the wall, and then we come back to the touchpad. A little bit of motion against the wall, then we come to the touchpad. And when you go away from the touchpad, I want you to do less. So you're going to be backing like this, and you're going to have to help her with the leash. As soon as you're in this position, so let's say there's a wall right here, you're going to do this. She's going to back here. Then you take your right turn, another left, and back to the touchpad. So that's the routine that you should begin to do to start to get her used to moving and staying in position. There's one other little element you might want to consider. When you are standing here and she's at Foose, it's you, your hand, and her. That's the way I did it all my life because I hate this sort of appearance. But because she's a nice tall dog, you can actually have you, her head, and your hand beside her. And I don't want you to walk like this. You see a lot of IPO people, especially at club trials, walking like this. This hand is going beside, but then this hand is way out there. So try to stand more like this with your hand slight on the other side of her head, slightly behind her head. So that when you turn, you'd actually be touching her head a little bit with your left hand. You don't have to, but I want her to feel comfortable with that left hand outside of her head, on the left side of her head, rather than inside. If your hand is always inside, then when you look down at her, she's gonna be sitting, she's gonna lean away and look up. And you want her to do look up and just turn her head slightly without leaning away. If you watch when Hug comes into a halt, if I stand there too long, he begins to lean away and look up. And it's because I've done 6.5 years of hand between me and him. And now I'm trying to change that. And it's really improving this heel dramatically. So that when I do a halt, my hand is here. If he tries to lean out, he touches my hand and it keeps him straight. Mm-hmm. It keeps him like this rather than like this, mm-hmm. and leaning away. Because if we start our heel for motion when she's like that, then she's gonna, as she straightens her head, she's gonna grab out a little bit. And we want her to just do this when you start walking forward. Okay. So the amount of time it takes to work on the touchpad on the floor is worth the time spending, because then when we start doing the actual routines, little obedience routines, then that's where this really pays off. So we want to be able to, when you're doing a healing routine, instead of doing long straights, you're just going to be doing a lot of left turns, a lot of backups, into a left turn, backups, into a left turn. That's going to keep her close, it's going to keep her straight, and if your hand is on the outside, it's going to keep her from leaning like this, which means she's going to turn her butt. And why lose the 2 points?
Yeah.
You know, when you're with her, your healing routine, she's at 98 to 100 point healing dog. I mean, she's gonna look absolutely beautiful, and I think when you get your pace down, she's gonna prance naturally. And if she prances naturally, man, is she going to look good. Because you're going to have this nice big female dog almost at your waist, prancing, and she'll look like this really strange looking horse walking a heel right next to you. It's a really beautiful picture. So that's what we're going for in the healing. So now we need to teach her to, she's already got a pretty good down on command. We learned her down straight, so keep doing your downs on a long wall and do it for motion. You're here. Plus, take a couple of steps. You want to watch to see when she, her elbows touch. You say yes, then turn around and place the treats. And instead of doing, you're doing it really fast, I want you to place a treat, stand up. Reach in your pocket, get another one, place a treat, stand up. And then start moving around a little bit so she stays stable, just like you've been doing. But start to work away from the wall a little bit. So that we can test to see if her muscle memory is going to make her down straight, which is important for the, especially for the, for your motion exercises in the BH. So this is what the most motion exercises in the BH look like. You're walking along, sit, and she sits, and then you walk forward 15 steps.
With or without her?
Without her. When you say sit, she should sit, and then you walk forward 15 steps. Turn around, face her, she's looking at you, and then you come back, get into basic position, and then you do your down. And your down is going to be like this. Now, she's got her plots, she's got her plots, and then you're going to walk 30 paces away, turn and recall her. So, you need the touchpad also for the recall. So that she comes in, the touch pad is right there, she puts her feet on it, sits, and she's nice and close. So all that stuff is still gonna be ongoing. I don't see any reason, how old is she now?
10 months.
10 months. It's gonna be the fall trial.
Yeah, that's what
for the VH. So that gives us plenty of time to get all this done. The goal would be you put her in the down or the sit, either one. You said, are you going to use here as the recall?
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you say, here, and she gets up, spins around, boom. So I'll have to probably, in the next week or so, I'll get some measurements. We're going to have to make a perch. You're going to have to make a perch with hot, little higher walls to create that really strong square.
You mean a long one?
Yeah,
I have that already.
Yeah, you have that already? Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you could even start now.
Okay.
Just bring it, don't say anything, just have the perch in front of you. She can be behind you, and basically what you're doing is you're leading her around so that she comes in and sits.
That's actually what we've been doing, but what I've had is the perch like this. She's gonna be on it now. So it's like that, and then I'll stand here and ask her to push up to the perch, and then here, right here, and she's actually doing pretty well.
So in other words, she gets off the placeboard and comes in.
Well, yeah, but I'm using a perch, not a placeboard.
Okay.
But this is generally what I'm doing, and then I'm asking her here and having her come and sit in front. So she's learning square because we're between a wall and
perch. And wall and the perch, great, that's fine.
So yeah,
there's nothing wrong with that at all. Okay, so you understand what you're going to be doing with the heel work and all that stuff?
Yeah, I hope so.
Alright, now I want to see you play.
For me? Oh.
Play. I want you to play with.
Yes.
Leave the phone call.
Okay. With whatever or the red one?
With whatever she likes. So start out with that. start holding the letter tug more like. With the handles hidden. And don't let go. In other words, you're not going to let go with one hand. So do you see what?
No, I don't need to guide her anymore. I need her back in. I've used it before.
See, so she's, instead of gripping, really hard, she's sort of holding, she'll grip it hard, but then she starts opening her mouth and wants to get it all the way in the back. So when she catches the tug, see, it's not a very hard bite. So, and part of that is because it's a hard leather tug, and even though she might like the feeling of it in her mouth, she's not really compressing.
She does better with, I have a rope toy that I'll do this with sometimes too. She actually will hold that better. Yeah. This one?
Do you like that one better?
I don't know, I don't like it.
So don't do this. If you're going to turn her, you do this. You turn her, then step into the turn and little tiny